Harvey was born on May 13, 1939. He was the youngest of three children, with an older brother and sister, but he knew that his father was not his biological father. Keitel's parents, Orthodox Jews, had escaped the rising tide of anti-Semitism in Europe. Emigrating to New York, where they settled in the Brighton Beach section of Brooklyn. Keitel said it was an incredibly colorful place to grow up. Brooklyn was a culture unto itself, Italian immigrants, Jewish immigrants, the music, the dances. His turf during his boyhood summers was the ocean and the nearby Coney Island amusement park. There were fireworks every Tuesday night in the summer, and an annual Mardi Gras at Coney Island, where the young Keitel would sell confetti. Home life was something else. I've had many problems in my life that I've had to get through, beginning with being a little boy, Keitel observed. He began stuttering at the age of 6 or 7, a problem that carried on into his teens. It was a huge, deep embarrassment, the object of humiliation by other children. Stuttering is an attempt to stop the assertion of the self. I still stutter at times. As an adolescent, in the Elvis era, when his peers were rocking and rolling, affecting the hairstyles and attitude of James Dean and Marlon Brando, none of which had penetrated the world of Keitel's parents. He battled with his parents against the rigid interpretation of life. His rebellion extended beyond attempts at blasphemy into his efforts to attain into juvenile delinquency. He wanted to be a tough guy because that's the way the guys were. As Keitel recalled it, you had to be tough, otherwise you were considered a fag, a sissy. For Keitel, being tough meant hiding his fear along with all the other unwanted, unwelcome emotions swirling around in his adolescent mind. Meanwhile, Keitel was discovering new paradigms for his notions of toughness in the movies of Marlon Brando and James Dean. The films showed the young Keitel that toughness could be associated with emotional honesty and not simply a readiness to be quick with the fists. I wasn't really becoming tough. I was building a stronger facade. I began to want to be less of a war hero and more of what those men were. They gave me courage, they gave me hope. The courage to express their feelings, their emotions, their thoughts. That was stunning. Frightening. It took more courage than I ever imagined, much more courage than picking up a gun. Don't be cruel to who heart is true. I don't want no other love. Oh baby, it's still you I'm thinking of.